8 Ways to Read Someone's Body Language. John Napier, a Scottish landowner known as a mathematician, physicist, and astronomer, said, "If language was given to men to conceal their thoughts, then gesture's purpose was to disclose them." Also, according to Deborah Bull, an English writer and broadcaster, body language is a very powerful tool. We had body language before we had speech. And apparently, 80% of what you understand in a conversation is read through the body, not the words. You may not realize this, but your body language is how you communicate to people and how you receive signals from others as well. For instance, imagine trying to invite a friend to your party, and although they accept your invitation, you sense that they don't seem pleased or happy. How will it make you feel? Good? Of course not. You rather that they don't attend the party because body language is given a negative vibe that you don't want at your party. Yes or yes? Now, if someone else were to ask you why don't you want that friend of yours at your party, even though they said they were happy to have been invited, what will you say? Their body language said otherwise, right? The question here is, how did you read their body language? How did you find out what their body language was saying? In this video, I'll share with you 8 ways to read someone's body language. This, I believe, will help you become a successful person. If you're new here, consider subscribing so that you won't miss other interesting videos like this. 1. Study the eyes. The eyes do a lot more talking than you can imagine. Sometimes they talk more than your mouth. Look at this, for instance. Say you wanted to signal at your friend that it's time to leave a place. What do you do? How do you say it? Your eyes. Because you do not want to talk at the time. All you need to do is look at the person and then glance at the wall clock or a wristwatch or anything that indicates that time is far spent, and boom, they get the message. You see, a person's eye can give away a lot of information without realizing it. When talking to someone, observe their eye movements. Are they making direct contact or looking away? Inability to make direct eye contact can indicate boredom, disinterest, or even deceit. If they are looking down, it might mean that they're nervous or submissive. The blinking rate of their eyes can say more about their stress level or if they are distracted. 2. Observe head movement. Do you know the speed at which a person nods their head while you're talking indicates their level of patience? While slow nodding indicates that a person is interested in what you're saying, fast nodding means just wrap up already so they can either talk or leave the room. Also, tilting one's head while talking with a person can be a sign of interest. They probably want you to say more about the topic as they are interested in finding out much more. This is a good sign to keep going on. 3. Notice their posture. Ludwig Wittgenstein, an Austrian philosopher, said, "The human body is the best picture of the human soul." Do you know how to recognize a person of authority in a room filled with so many people? It's mostly their body posture. Standing up straight with your shoulders back is a power position. Slouching, on the other hand, is the result of collapsing your form, which projects less power. When a person maintains a good posture, you can easily engage with them, unlike when they are slouching. 4. See if the other person is mirroring you. Mirroring body language is something we do unconsciously when we feel a bond with each other person. It's a sign that the conversation is going well and that the other party is receptive to your message. For instance, if you're sitting at a table with someone and rest an elbow on the table and they copy this position a few seconds later, or every time you cross or uncross your legs they do the same, then you can tell that they are interested in the conversation as they are unconsciously mimicking you. 5. Watch out for hand signals. Hand signals give out a lot of information when conversing with a person. For instance, if a person puts their hand in their pocket or in their head while talking with them, it might indicate nervousness or deceit. On the other hand, when a person is constantly pointing in one direction during a meeting, saying your direction, that can indicate their interest in you. 6. Observe their feet. When people try to control their body language, they focus primarily on facial expressions, body postures, and hand and arm gestures, forgetting to monitor their hands and feet. When they are stressed or tense, their feet will fidget, shuffle, and wind around each other or the furniture. To relieve tension, however, they will stretch their feet. 7. Crossed arms and legs might indicate resistance to you. Crossed arms and legs are physical barriers that suggest the other person is not open to what you're saying. Psychologically, crossed legs or arms signal that a person is mentally, emotionally, and physically blocked off from what is in front of them. 8. Pay attention to proximity. Proximity is the distance between you and the person. Paying attention to how close a person stands or sits to you while having a conversation can signify if they are interested or not. When a person moves away when you move in closer during a conversation, it could mean that they are not connecting or bonding with you. Note that some cultures, however, prefer less or more distance during an interaction. So, posture might not be a good judge of body language at all times. Thank you very much for watching our videos. We'll like to give you another interesting video for you to enjoy next. But before then, our team will be very happy if you can like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss other interesting videos like this. Look at your screen now to see two other videos we handpicked for you to enjoy next. We love you.